Narrator. Once upon a time, in the game takes of the USA, there were three Anteaters living in a forest. One of them was in a little cave barrow having some termites in a bowl. Now you might be thinking, well, that's stupid. Why would anteaters want to live together? They are mostly solitary animals. And you might also be thinking, Andy Anteater, bro, why would we be eating termites when we eat ants? But you may also be thinking this, Mama Anteater, are you kidding me? Why would we be living in a cave like a barrow? Narrator, well, this is a fairy tale. Not everything's gonna make sense, so get over it. Anyways, as I was saying, these three Anteaters live together, but then they came across a problem. Dot Anteater, honey, you ran out of termites. Why does this always happen when you get the termites? Mommy Anteater, well, it's not my fault. Termites have been more scarce lately. Stop making excuses, Loretta. This is your fault. Andy Anteater, can you guys stop arguing about termites? I mean, I don't like it when my parents argue, dude. Mom and Dad, Anteater, Andy, we are not arguing. Andy Anteater, well, if you both care so much about the termites, then let's get some. So, by settles before the termites, and then Goldilocks was walking around in the forest, and then she found that Anteater's huge barrow and climbed into it to find that it was the source of a huge house and find three bowls of hot porridge. It didn't have termites. The bowls of porridge did not have termites in it since they ran out of termites, so it was edible for people. This porridge looks so good. Let me try it. Everyone, crack. Goldilocks dropped the bowl on the floor because it was way too hot. Goldilocks, maybe this bowl will be better. Ow, 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 hot, hot, hot. Everyone, crack. Narrator, Goldilocks dropped the bowl again because it was too hot. Now Goldilocks' tongue is burning. Poor Goldilocks. Goldilocks, this will be the perfect one. I know it. Ow! Owie! Hot! I'm so hot! My tongue! What pie! What torture! Everyone, crack! As you can see, and probably too, Goldilocks is pretty stupid because all three bowls came from the same steaming pot. So if the first one was hot, then the second and the third one would be hot too. So maybe if Goldilocks used her brain, then she wouldn't have made such a mess, especially since all three bowls were steaming. Goldilocks, whoa! Whoa! Look at these styrofoam beanbags! Narrator, Goldilocks got on the chair and jumped on the styrofoam bag and did the same thing to the other two styrofoam bags, which made all three styrofoam bags explode. Goldilocks, stupid styrofoam beans. Narrator, Goldilocks got tired of breaking things, so she looked for a bed. But since Anteaters lived there, there weren't any beds. So she found an MP3 player, which was Andy's, and she listened to his rock music. And since the music was so high up, Goldilocks couldn't hear the Anteaters into their house. With finding new termites. Well, finding new termites is what I mean. Andy Anteater, bro, I hear this some girl jamming to my tunes, but really badly. I'm typical for school. Oh my gosh, my porridge! Mom, my styrofoam beans! Goldilocks, a giant human-sized talking elk! Ah! Mom, Anteater, excuse me, but we are Anteaters? Narrator, but before Mom and Anteater could even finish her sentence, Goldilocks was out the door, termites.